Hello, I'm EnterElysium and welcome back to From the Depths. This is the Wing Zero taking her on her sea trials, and let's be honest, she's not doing so great. Anyway, the enemy force is like right there bearing down on us, so we need to like go back to base quickly. They are literally about to start battle, and the Wing Zero is about to sink. I probably should have turned the engine off before I left. It's good for the environment and all that. Hup. 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 Down. Ready, 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 ready. Jump! I should have just teleported. I can teleport. I forget that. Right. B. And R. Delete. I need to put the tractor beam over here so it's next to all the tentacles and stuff. And quickly. Grab the Wing Zero. Select this vehicle. On. And hold azimuth 90 degrees. Yes. Right. You all have to fight from there. Also, I want to edit this gun. Because they are coming over that hill, and our lasers for designating enemy targets are, like, directly at the hill, and they're probably going to load in on the wrong side of the that mountain, like that island. And that island is going to block our missiles from getting to them, which is annoying. The only thing that can really hit them is going to be this cannon, because it's going to fire in an arc, because projectile goes up, gravity happens, it comes down. The missiles don't. They ride down the beam. Well, they're not beam riders, but they do, you know, aim for the beam, and the beam is hitting a mountain, so they'll go, oh, I got to hit the mountain. So I need this cannon to be an anti-ship cannon right now. It's kind of a crappy anti-air cannon, actually. I mean, I had a look at another look at it, and I'm not entirely happy with it for anti-air. I mean, it's okay, but we really need it to take out ships. So we need to, like, massively increase the gauge. So I would like to put a mirror line down. Gauge increase. Right, underneath them. Right, underneath. 1, 2, 3, 4... Let's do all of those. Right, what does that give me in the way of gauge? 900 kinetic damage. I am happy with that. I could increase it a little bit more. But it's too late. It's time for fight. Would you like to view this? Yep. Okay. I guess we're going to start our fight. How do I start the fight? Do I click on you? Click on you. You should have like a little X and I can be like, I'm going to stab you. No? Why is the home base moving? Come back here. The Wing Zero is still there. The bushel is... I want behind the lines. Home base is moving back. Okay. Oh, there we go. There's the fight. Excellent. Begin the fight. Okay, right. Out of that map mode. Oh, no. Actually, in that map mode. We want the bushel in last. Not that it matters. I think everyone's going to spawn in. Yeah, everyone's going to spawn in. Okay. Begin the battle. It's the time you've been waiting for. Oh, God. That's so loud. I'm going to hide. I think this turret is broken. Let's go fly the camera over and see how things are going. Nice. Good, good. The cannon is doing what I want it to do. Not enough damage. Marauders are pretty large. The Marauders aren't totally dangerous. They have a broadside, but their broadside is pretty low powered. What you have to be aware of with them is they're quite tanky for an early ship. This guy's a little bit scary. Oh. That guy's got, These are like missiles that are like only like too long, and basically they're magnetic and they just fling them out using the ejectors. Oh, they've got a flying thing. We'll come back to you in a minute. And those are going to like hit the water and then go blomp, blomp, blomp and float towards us and then magnetically grab onto us. So I actually want to raise the station up and I can do that. So let us head back to me. I'm going to get inside because it's not safe out here. Up. Oh god, the flying thing isn't being targeted. Why are we not targeting the flying thing? Oh, we are, but not enough. Right, I'm going to take control of the missile turret that doesn't seem to be doing anything. I think it's broken. Yeah, I don't think it's controlling the turret. I think it's only controlling the... Actually, I'm not sure, but I'm going to take control of it anyway. Right. Good. Keep it up. I know I didn't know what to do with about the fighter, but... This is a way. Yes. Big chunks out of you. Big chunks. Are you still flying? You're just releasing more air balloons. Ah, you want to stay up. Okay. Am I reloaded? One missile. There we go. There's my missiles. Okay, go, 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 go. Okay, you should be down. I imagine that's down. Oh god, that's something exploded right next to me. Are we good? We're okay. It didn't go through the armor. He's still not dead. Okay, well, we're gonna take control of the missile turret and sort that out. Come, missile turret. Turn. Ah, that's why. All right, I'm not controlling the missile turret. I'm controlling the missiles. Not the turret. Right, turn, turn, turn. You're too damaged. We need to confirm this. I think that's the broadside of the Wing Zero targeting it currently. I wonder if I can hop on board and steal its AI. No, it's gone. It's gone. Okay. Oh. One thing I might want to do is that thruster craft down there is not being targeted by anyone. Oh, we exploded something. I hope that's we exploded something, not the enemy. Come on, we got you. We got you. We got you. We got you. Ready? I've only got three missiles, but they'll do. Didn't do as much damage as I'd want. That's more like it. Okay, right. We're gonna... I think we're actually gonna go in person to take out that last marauder. Oh god. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Yeah. Oh no, that was the back of the bush. The back of the Wing Zero got blown off. Oh, there are the mine thingies I told you about. The back of the Wing Zero got blown off. Ah, that damn fighter. Ah, there's no way for us to really stop it at the moment. I mean, we could take control of the missiles and shoot it, but its time will come. What I want to do is I want to board the enemy craft and try and capture them, and then I can use their resources better. Because right now, every time we get hit, we're getting like 0.7... We're getting 7% of the resources. But if I go in manually and take control, I can capture them. Now, it's a little bit cheaty in some ways, because they can't really fight back. There is an element of, you know, skill to it, but mostly it's a cheaty way, which is why I don't do it much. I'm gonna do it right now because we haven't, like, got fully prepared. They're the other side of this hill, otherwise we would have minced some of our missiles. And it'll just speed it up, make it a bit more interesting. Right now, only having the cannon able to hit them is a bit annoying. And it's because they're not coming- Oh god, I got hit by the- Oh, I'm at 41% health. Ow. It's because they won't come around, because their AI is stupid. Yeah, look at them, they're beached. Although... Grenade launcher, three. Geronimo! That didn't really work. Can I jump? I'm unable to jump. There we go. Where do you house your AI? I have no idea where they house their AI, but I'm gonna try and find a way in. Okay, right. This looks like an AI. That's a transmitter. I need to... Can I move back? I'll move over here. Yeah, that's an AI. Take this. Right. I'm gonna switch to my blunderbuss. Let me at it. Let me at- Oh god, that's fuel down there. I don't want to land on that. This is too slow. Grenades! Because my things are still shooting. Oh, whoops. My things are still shooting at it. Like, that's a shell just came in there. I need to kill it before it gets killed by my own, like, weapons. No, God! Is it mine? It's mine! It's getting attacked by the one next to it. That's what all these cannon rounds coming in are. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. That's not a staircase. Oh God, I'm sorry to do this to you. You've just captured you, but needs must. Ow, 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 ow. Oh, ow, ow, ow. Right, come here. Ready? Jump. That's not a jump. Why can I not jump on these slopes? Oh, she's getting broadsided. Right, same place for the AI. Blow our way down. By the way, we're losing resources at the moment because we're getting more and more damaged on our lovely new ship, so if we can get both of them, I'll be happy. Because right now, like, who's actually shooting? Is the cannon, like, from the base even... Blow away in. And then just a few grenades through that hole. Come on, we got this. Oh yeah! We've got two marauders. And how many resources are you worth? 60,000 metals. That's the only one I'm really interested in. They're worth 60,000 metal each. Well, depending on the, you know, state of repair. Which isn't too bad, actually. Now, I won't normally do boarding actions like that because they're a little bit cheaty, but when we're stuck behind a bleeding hill like that... Oh, God. Don't blow up. I need you. Oh, don't fall on... That's the ammo stockpile. Oh, God. I need to get out of here. Eek. I'm going to teleport back home. So yeah, we did take a massive explosion to the rear of the Wing Zero. It's a bit messy. Anyway, what was I saying about the Wing Zero? Yeah, I did some work off camera, which I never really got to tell you about, and I didn't finish plating it with metal because the enemy came before we could finish the plating. So the Wing Zero is unfinished and now blooded. Bloodied, more like. The Wing Zero is not doing too well. I did, however, do some work off camera, which I will get to show you in a second. Well, more work off camera. I mean, like, more work... It'll become obvious in a bit. But yeah, currently, she's not even able to really float. Otherwise, I would have taken her around and made her fight the enemy rather than me going over there and doing it. But yeah, currently, she capsizes and she pretends to use a submarine at a moment's notice. In addition to the fact, like, she blew up. Right, if I take everyone out of play, map mode, pull all, I would like to heal you, and if I can get them to move over here somewhere, like near the base, there we go, I'll just speed up time a little bit. So they're getting healed. Why is the Elysian home base not in the center? I need to give you a fortress AI, I really do. Let me put the Wing Zero here. I don't want this marauder directly on top of the base, please. Oh, God damn it, this is a pain in the... It's because technically the Wing Zero is a flagship, so the fortress is moving relative to our flagship. And it just gets messy. Go to 10 times speed. Okay, now I can go to map mode. Spawn. And there are marauders. Ooh, the paint scheme's also changed to match our paint scheme. Oh, yay. Now, I would take the marauders for us, but they're actually really annoying. I hate paddle wheels. I don't know how to control paddle wheels. because they just continue going forwards, and then they end up ramming things like an island, and you can never get them back. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to scrap them. For good. Good reasons. We have very good reasons. We can go here. I would like you to get the Marauder and scrap the Marauder. And you see it's disappearing slowly. And our metal is going up. And tasty resources. Okay, so let's grab the other Marauder.
No!
And our resources are still going up. Beautiful. And we have nearly 100,000 metal, which is just about sufficient for what I want to do now. Let's firstly go to... Can I use you to destroy stuff? Is it... No, it's you I have to use to destroy stuff, right? Yeah, because I click this, right? And it's like, oh, the Marauder has zero health. And I'm going to go destroy scrapped object completely. I have a Marauder, destroy scrapped object completely. Because you could keep them at zero health and then just be able to, like, repair them to full health, but I'm not gonna. So, this is the wing zero currently. It's not finished. Needs a lot of work done. And it's missing a lot of its hull plating and, you know, a fair amount of armament. It could do with its a deck gun and maybe, like, another thing here. So I did do some work on it, surprisingly, that we can now do. And I think people appreciate this. Now, I did get a lot of feedback on what people want in terms of fighting and building. And there are people who really want building. Remember that some of you who've, like, seen lots of this game played, there's quite a lot of people on my channel, in fact, probably the majority, haven't actually seen this game at all. So they do actually like to see a bit of the building part. Now, if it's helpful, I will do, like, a tutorial series on some of the building stuff. Like, you know, baby's first engine or whatever. But for now, I will cover the building stuff occasionally. Mainly when I'm doing, like, new things, like new cannons, etc. So right now, I'm just putting down some repair tentacles so I can show you this lovely new thing. Now, repair tentacles are actually, like, really cheap. So I think that's enough. Okay. So, this is the Wing Zero. Still not really finished, but that's fine. Because we're going to do some magic to it. So if I go to you, no, I have to go to you. Aha! I go to the Wing Zero. I'm going to put my rocket launcher away. Oh, grenade launcher? That's probably a bad thing to have out. V. The Wing Zero. Blah, 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 blah. Costs 50,000 metal, etc., etc., etc. We go retrofit. I can then go to YouTube campaign. Wing Zero frigate. And you can see the retrofit costs. So this is what this costs. Compared to what this costs. So currently our ship costs 50,000 metal. The Wing Zero frigate, the version 16, costs 110,000 metal. That's kind of expensive. There's a reason for that. But oh my god, that is rather expensive. We do, however, have the metal for it. So, boom. That destroys anything that's not in the original design, and I'm stuck under that. And then the repair tentacles start fixing it to the new design. So, I'm going to jump up here, and I'm gonna get this to hold the Wing Zero. Maybe we'll move it a little bit closer. Doesn't have to be quite so far away. I don't know why it's rolling. Did I accidentally put roll on?
Ah!
Really? Zero. I don't know what that's all about. Anyway, ta-da! Okay, so this is a deck turret that's actually going to be mounted in the bottom there, and it's going to have a lot of its innards actually inside the ship, which means it doesn't have to be as bulky on the outside. It's a really cunning idea that I had when looking at some of the stock ones. It's got lots of shields. It's got an anti-air missile battery here that I really like. I really like this anti-air missile battery. It's got a hind castle that can see over everything. It's got, of course, the lovely Elysian flag. And it's got a little command bit for me that's really annoying to get. I need to fix this. Really? There we go. And you see that it's got shields protecting me. Huh. Oh, this lovely anti-air battery. And you can see the cannon here. That was really quick build. I like the... It's finished? Nice. This is the Wing Zero. Oh, yeah. So let us take a quick look. Four large propellers on the back. This thing can get to about 10 meters per second in the water, so it's pretty nippy. It's got an anti-missile laser battery here and here. It has all the side guns. A bit improved, made a bit more accurate, because I found that they just weren't like that good when using a broadside. They just missed constantly. Like in that fight there, they were just, ugh. So I did a little bit of work on them in the vehicle designer. I've increased the bow thrusters and the stern thrusters to 4 rather than 2. I've put shields on all over the place. Now, the turret has its own shield as well to protect it. And if we go boop and then shrink, you can see that the turret actually sinks into the deck here. So it's actually mounted here, right above the torpedoes, and it has a lot of its innards right down here. And then it goes up to here. Now, this turret isn't like the most effective turret in the world. If we have a quick look. Oh, I need to go to the turret. There we go. There we go. Turret is reload time of over 7 seconds, but it does do 900 kinetic, 200 explosive, and it's got an AP that will get it through metal. Inaccuracy of 1.17. So it's actually, you know, not a bad turret. It's not, of course, the main armament, but it's pretty damn good. The main arm, of course, of this is still its missiles, but it's a pretty damn good secondary. And it should be able to do a fair amount of damage when it gets in close. Of course, you know, the reload time is a bit on the slow side. But, you know, I like the idea of the gun there. I think it was, you know, a cool idea to have. I'm happy to have it. So let's go back to the rest of the ship. It's still got the old-fashioned missiles. You see the cruise missiles there, and then the anti-air missiles here. And then here, it's got something amazing. I really love this. This is actually a missile that I am really proud of. It is a laser designate. It's not a laser designate, sorry. It's a laser beam riding kinetic kill vehicle missile. So I call them kinetic kill vehicles. I believe that's a military term for them. Basically, they use kinetic impact. So if we have a quick look, they've got a thumper warhead. So a thumper warhead isn't explosive, isn't frag. It just does damage through its sheer kinetic energy. So however fast it's moving, more damage. However much more it weighs, more damage. And it has a laser beam rider. So the thumper warhead has to go on the front, which means you can't have any of the normal guidance. The one guidance you can have is the laser beam rider. The laser beam rider looks behind itself, looks where the laser is, and tries to make sure it's on it. But of course it can't really look behind itself because there's like a missile in the way. So it waves from side to side, sort of going backwards and forwards over the beam. And it gives it sort of like this squiggly kind of flight path. It's unique among the missiles in that regard. It's got plenty of fuel tanks, 2 variable thrusters and 2 fins. Now fins go on the back because it's got the most drag coefficient at the back and the least at the front, and fins have a high drag. And the variable thrusters are turned up pretty high. You see it's on 10,000, that one's on 10,000. These things are badass. They'll get to about a kilometer, and they will do massive damage. They will go straight through wood, and they will put a massive dent in metal, and there are 6 of them. They're badass. They are amazing for taking down flying vehicles, because they move so fast that flying vehicles just, they don't stand much of a chance, really. I did test this sort of design. I was testing missiles, basically. I wanted to see how the new thumper warheads worked, and I was trying them out in the vehicle designer against shrikes, which are the Deepwater Guards, like, bombers that are really incredibly tough in the early game. They just mint shrikes. They don't give a damn. They just mince them. And this turret can actually not just turn, but it can also elevate. So it makes it a bit vulnerable. If they hit this, then the entire thing is broken. But it has a shield on to kind of protect that little bit. But it can turn, and it can shoot basically anywhere except for when it sort of gets jammed on the hind castle. If we have a quick look down below, you can see... Oh, wrong one. There we go. You can see we have plenty of ammo down here. We have 2 layers of metal on the rear, and 3 layers of metal. 1, 2, 3 on the side. I was a bit wary. This ammo stock barrel is very large. Now, a few people have said, why don't you use, like, ammo reloaders, aren't they called? I think they're called ammo reloaders. Basically, like, it makes ammo for you from your metal. And you don't have to have quite so many ammo barrels. Yeah, that is a good point, but I don't have enough metal to run them, because they turn your metal into ammo. I need my metal. Like, I can't build another one of these ships. I only have a third of the amount this ship would need to make another one, so I cannot afford to spend my ammo like that. So I have to have large ammo barrels, which makes me a little bit vulnerable, as happened in the last battle. We also have these lasers, right? So these lasers are not offensive. They're used to shoot down enemy missiles. And if we have a look where they go, right here, there's one, row of lasers stuff here, one row of laser stuff here, and a big center one that runs over the top of the engine here. I'm proud of this. This is a sexy beast. The Wing Zero is a sexy beast indeed. Now, of course, I will be showing you lasers later on, and I will explain, you know, how the building process of lasers works, etc., for those of you new to the game. I just wanted to quickly build an anti-laser thing in here and just see if I could fit it in. And I got a little bit carried away. It was meant to be a cheap frigate, and you know me. I can't build anything cheap. It has to be awesome. Now, the one main thing that made it expensive was this craft is incredibly heavy. Incredibly heavy. I mean, ridiculously heavy. It was a sub. It was a submarine. I'm sorry. And I had to go through the entire deck and replace all the metal with lightweight metal alloy, which actually floats and is an eighth of the weight. It now floats. It handles pretty well, but it's a lot more expensive. Now, actually, the weakest part on the entire ship is directly below the commander's chair. There is wood, because I wanted a wood deck. And then there is, I think, your light metal alloy. Can I check that? I think your light metal alloy. I can't tell. I think you like light metal alloy. Anyway, and that means that directly above the ammo, it's not particularly well protected. That said, there is a shield emitter here. There is a shield emitter up here on the bridge. There's a shield emitter on the side of the bridge. And there is, in fact, a shield emitter here on the side of the ammo stockpile. I am making sure this ammo stockpile does not get hit. I am taking no chances. And if we have a quick look at the side guns. Boop. Inactive 2.5. Reload time of just under 4 seconds. They're not too bad. Now, the azimuth in the elevation is 15-15. I'm not sure I want that. I think I want more. I think I might have to have a word with that. I might have a, you know, play around with that off camera. I think it's meant to have a motor-driven barrel here and doesn't. Or a motor-driven barrel here and here. Something like that. I think I've screwed that up. But I'll have to have a look to that off camera. Because that elevation and stuff, it's meant to be 45-45. But I'll work on that off camera. And yeah, I guess we'll end it here for this episode. We had a big fight. We now have a fully-fledged HMS Wing Zero. We won't take the fight to the enemy yet, because if we lose the Wing Zero, our base is going to get destroyed. But the enemy are probably going to come for us after what we just did to them, so I don't think the next battle is going to be too far away. Let's look at the map. Oh, hello. Well, I predicted that one, right? What are you? Swordfish, patchwork, scuttlegun. We can take you. We have a ship. We could almost go out and meet you. I mean, we probably could. But the risk is if we lose the ship due to a lucky ammo stockpile hit, then we're screwed. I want to have two ships so that I can, you know, be a little bit sure about what we're doing. And I think our plan will then be to take this resource zone and we'll leave like a little fortress here and move our big fortress over. Yeah, that seems like a good idea. But anyway, I've been EnterElysium. We're going to end the episode here. From now on out, there will be fighting for quite a while, it looks like. And they are moving at a fair clip towards us, but if you've liked, remember to like, not subscribe. Please consider subscribing. I cannot wait to start actually captaining the Wing Zero. This is going to be so much fun. Until next time, stay shiny.